Nanobubble oxygenation for recirculating aquaculture systems to increase fish production. A project at the University of Wisconsin, Stevens Point, Northern Aquaculture Demonstration Facility. Dissolved oxygen is one of the most critical factors in determining the stocking density and production yield in recirculating aquaculture systems, referred to as RAS. Poor oxygen levels can exert negative influences on feeding, feed conversion, growth, and fish health. Traditional diffused aeration is limited by temperature, salinity, and altitude on oxygen solubility and will generally not effectively support commercial fish densities. Various devices have been employed to raise oxygen further, such as low-head oxygenators, U-tubes, packed columns, and oxygenation cones. By using pure oxygen and gas transfer devices, stocking densities can be greatly increased. While these methods have increased production levels, they still have a limit to how high they can go. The University of Wisconsin Stevens Point Northern Aquaculture Demonstration Facility is currently investigating a novel technology for oxygen supplementation in recirculating aquaculture systems, referred to as nanobubble technology. Nanobubbles are miniature gas bubbles with less than 200 nanometers in diameter that have been shown to have unique physiological benefits for fish. Nanobubbles can also more efficiently catalyze reactions of chemicals, thereby improving the efficiency of recirculating water treatment. Nanobubbles may also enhance activities of microbes and improve biofiltration in recirculating aquaculture systems, or RAS. They are an environmentally friendly technique that could possibly reduce the size of filtration systems, resulting in significant potential for design and operational cost reduction. The presence of stable nanobubbles in water has been experimentally confirmed, yet little applied research on the mechanisms of the physical and biological effects of nanobubbles has been completed. Additionally, even with a limited amount of work that has focused on the effect of nanobubbles on fish growth rate and health, the role of increased dissolved oxygen due to the use of nanobubbles has not been separated from the physiological effect of the nanobubble itself. The University of Wisconsin Stevens Point Northern Aquaculture Demonstration Facility and partners have been funded by the National Sea Grant College program to study the revolutionary potential of nanobubbles in RAS. To perform the research, the UWSP NADF has recently constructed 6 replicated, independent recirculating aquaculture systems at the state-of-the-art facility in Bayfield, Wisconsin. Each system includes temperature control, UV sterilization, biofiltration, solids removal, and oxygen supplementation. Further monitoring of temperature and dissolved oxygen of each system is achieved with a YSI 5500D optical monitoring and control instrument, which is used in tandem with a solenoid valve to control oxygen supplied to the system. These systems will be used to compare the nanobubble technology to oxygen cones and diffusers, which are other types of oxygen delivery systems that supply pure oxygen in RAS. The research will document the differences in amounts of oxygen needed, as well as the overall power required for maintaining the same amount of oxygen levels using the identified delivery systems. This project will compare the various oxygen delivery systems for both cool water species utilizing walleye and also cold water species utilizing Atlantic salmon. The project will determine a cost-benefit analysis model for the use of nanobubbles in RAS and also characterize nanobubbles to better understand their chemistry in an RAS, as well as their effects on the growth and health of fish and water quality in cool and cold water RAS. For more information and to view results from this project, please visit aquaculture.uwsp.edu.